Computer system design. Classification of computers. Classification of computers is divided in three categories for both data handling functionality. In purpose, we have general and specific purpose. In data handling, there is analog, digital, and hybrid. In functionality, there are four sizes: super, mainframe, mini, micro. And in micro, there is two categories: desktop and portable. Here, the classification of computers. Supercomputer, mainframe, mini computer, workstation. Then types of personal computers are desktop PC, all-in-one PC, laptop, notebook, netbook, handheld computer. Then in types of handheld computers are tablets, pocket PC, and wearable computer. Here is the lecture. Let's study what are these. Supercomputer. Supercomputer are large systems that are specifically designed to solve complex scientific and industrial challenges. Such applications span a wide range of computational intensive tasks, including quantum mechanics, weather forecasting, climate research, and oil and gas exploration, molecular dynamics, and physical simulations, and require an amount of computing power and resources that go beyond what is available in general purpose. Computer servers or workstations. Some supercomputers are made of thousands of connected processors, and their speed has grown exponentially over the past few years, decades. Common applications for supercomputers include testing mathematical models for complex physical phenomena or design, such as climate and weather, evolution of the cosmos, nuclear weapons and reactor, new chemicals compound, especially for pharmaceutical purposes and cryptology. Here is the photo of the supercomputer. It is the largest computer and has the biggest functionality. Here in mainframe computer, at their core, mainframes are high-performance computers with large amounts of memory and processors that process billions of simple calculations and transactions in real time. The mainframe is critical to commercial databases, transaction servers, and applications that require high resiliency, security, and agility. The main difference between mainframes and supercomputers is their typical application domain. Mainframes excel in reliable volume computing in domains requiring integer operation. Despite the continued change in IT, mainframe computers considered by many to be the most stable and secure and compatible of all computing platforms. The latest model can handle the most advanced and demanding consuming workloads, yet continue to run applications that were written in earlier decades. For those who think there is no use for the big iron, they would really be surprised. The truth is that we are all mainframe users in one way or another. Mainframes are a smaller version of supercomputers and are specific for data and collecting billions of data. Here is a mini computer. A mini computer is a type of computer that possesses most of the features and capabilities of a large computer but is smaller in physical size. A mini computer fills the space between the mainframe and microcomputer and is smaller than the former but larger than the latter. Mini computers are mainly used as small or mid-range servers operating business and scientific applications. However, the use of the term mini computer has diminished and has merged with servers. A mini computer may also be called a mid-range computer. Mini computers were made in the mid-1960s and were first developed by IBM Corporation. They were primarily designed for business applications and services that require the performance and efficiency of mainframe computers. Mini computers are generally used as mid-range servers where they can operate mid-sized software applications and support numerous users simultaneously. Mini computers may contain one or more processors, will support multi-processing and tasking, and are generally resilient to high workloads. Although they are smaller than mainframe or supercomputers, mini computers are powerful than personal computers and workstations. Workstation. A workstation is a special computer designed for technical or scientific application, intended primarily to be used by one person at a time. They are commonly connected to a local area network and run multi-user operating system. A workstation is a computer intended for individual use that is faster and far more capable than a personal computer. It's intended for business or professional use. Workstation and application designed for them and are used by small engineering companies, architects, graphic designers, and any organization, department, or individual that requires a faster microprocessor, a large amount of random access memory RAM, special features such as high-speed graphic adapters. Historically, the workstation developed technologically about the same time and for the same objects as the Unix operating system, which is often used the workstation operating system. Among the most successful makers of this kind of workstation are Sun Microsystems, Hewlett-Packard, DEC, and IBM. In IBM and other corporations, the term workstation is sometimes used to mean any individual workstation, personal computer location hookup to a mainframe computer. Personal computers, PC. A personal computer is a general purpose cost-effective computer that is designed to be used by a single end user. Every PC is dependent on microprocessor technology, which allows PC maker to set the entire central processing unit, CPU, on a single chip. Businesses make use of PCs to perform tasks like accounting, desktop publishing, and word processing, as well as to run databases and spreadsheets. At home, PCs are mainly used for multimedia entertainment, playing PC games, accessing the internet, etc. Even though PCs are intended to use a single user system, it is normal to connect them together to create a network, such as local area network LAN. Can be a microcomputer, desktop computer, a laptop computer, a tablet PC, or a handheld PC. In the mid-1960s and into the 1970s, computers occupied entire rooms were only affordable by large universities and enterprises. These early computers were accessed by multiple users via touch terminals. Resources were shared among all users. The term PC became popular in the early 1980s, building on Time Magazine's choice of PC as the Man of the Year for 1982. By the late 1980s, technology had advanced far enough that a small computer could be used and owned by a single individual. In 1981, IBM came into the arena by introducing its first personal computer. There was the IBM PC. The IBM PC rapidly became popular in the market. Only a few companies could survive the popularity of IBM PCs, including Apple, which remained a leading provider in the PC market. Later, other manufacturers adapted to the PC trend advanced by IBM by developing IBM clones. Clones were PC with almost the same configuration as IBM PCs, but at a lower price. Gradually, IBM lost their dominance in the PC arena. Recently, as of 2012, the realm of PCs mainly divided between Apple, Macintosh, and PCs from other manufacturers. PCs usually consist of the following parts: computer case, power supply, motherboard, random access memory, hard disk, CD or DVD drives or writers, various external devices such as visual display, keyboard, printer, and pointing devices. Types of personal computer. Desktop PC. A desktop computer or desktop PC is a computer that is designed to stay in a single location. It may be a tower, also known as system unit, or an all-in-one machine such as iMac. Unlike laptops and other portable devices, desktop computers cannot be powered from an internal battery and therefore must remain connected to a wall outlet. In the early age of computers, desktop computers were the only personal computers available. Since laptops and tablets did not exist, all home PCs were desktop computers. So the term desktop computer was used back then to differentiate between personal PCs and larger computers, such as mainframes and supercomputers. While desktop computers were the most popular type of personal computers for several decades, in recent years, laptops have surpassed those of desktop PCs because of the rise in mobile computing. This trend is likely to continue. However, Desktop computers remain the most popular choice for business workstation and family computers. All-in-one PC. All-in-one PCs or AOO PCs are streamlined desktop computers that integrated all of the components of a traditional desktop computer. Except for the keyboard and mouse into the single unit, AIO PCs offer several advantages over traditional desktop computers. Aside from saving the space and having fewer cables, they are considered to be user-friendly and pleasant to use. Thanks to in part of their large touchscreen interfaces, these types of PC are also renowned for typical offering as much or more performance than a laptop or other mobile computer. It's a computer that combines all desktop computers in one enclosed unit instead of having a separate computer tower from the display monitor. Laptop computer is a small personal computer. They are designed to be more portable than traditional desktop computers. With many of the same abilities, laptops are able to be folded flat for transportation and have a built-in keyboard and touchpad. Most laptops are powerful enough for everyday business, administrative, home, or sole use. However, if a user does graphical work such as 3D rendering or movie encoding, a more advanced and powerful laptop is needed. As advanced as laptops are, the top-end ones still cannot compete with high-power desktop and workstation where processing power is needed. Your line of work will detect the laptop type you need. Since there are so many options, it's important to know what laptops with different specifications can do so that you can choose the right one for your business and budget. A laptop computer is smaller than a desktop, generally less than 3 inches thick, and weighs less than desktop computers. The laptop size market makes it convenient for transportation, briefcases, backpacks, and other bags. The device derives its name from being able to be used by resting on a person's lap without the need for a desk or other surface. Laptop computers may also be referred to as notebook computers. So, a notebook computer usually describes a computer that is smaller and lighter than a laptop computer. Notebook. A laptop computer is a battery or AC-powered personal computer, generally smaller than a briefcase that can easily be transported and conveniently used in temporary spaces such as in airplanes, in library, temporary offices, and at meetings. Notebooks usually come with displays that use thin screen technology. A notebook computer, sometimes called a laptop computer, typically weighs less than 5 tons and is 3 inches or less in thickness. Among the best known makers of notebook and laptop computers are IBM, Apple, Compaq, Dell, Toshiba, and Hewlett-Packard. Notebook computers generally cost more than desktop computers with the same capabilities because they are more difficult to design and manufacture. A notebook can effectively be turned into a desktop computer with a docking situation, a hardware frame that supplies connection for peripheral input and output devices, such as printer or larger monitor. The less capable port replicator allows you to connect a notebook to a number of peripherals through a single plug. Notebooks usually come with displays that use thin screen technology. The thin film transistor or active matrixing is brighter and used better at different angles than the STN or dual scan screen. Notebooks use several different approaches for integrating a mouse into the keyboard, including the touchpad, the trackball, and the pointing stick. A serial port also allows a regular mouse to be attached. The PC card is insertable hardware for adding a modem or a network interface to a notebook. CDROM means digital versatile disk drives may be built-in or attachable. Netbook. A netbook is a marketing medium used in the past for small, low-performance, legacy-free, and expensive laptop. A notebook is a device that can perform the majority of the function of a desktop or laptop but is extremely mobile. Books look like miniature laptop with screens rarely exceeding 10 or 12 inches. The netbook ranks the economical mobile market for some time, particularly amongst users who primarily purchase the device for web browsing on the go. Their trip service provider offer plans for data cards so users can plug into the netbook and browse directly on a mobile device network. Many tech blogs noted the netbook's revolutionary impact on mobile browsing and highlighted the device as a game changer to the laptop industry. Handheld computers. A handheld PC is the term for miniature computer typically built around a clamshell form factor and is significantly smaller than any standard laptop computer. But based on some principle, a highly mobile and compact computer, also called a PDA, personal digital assistant, originally built to function as a personal scheduling assistant. Today, handheld computers frequently provide a convenient connection to the internet using wireless technology. They're immensely popular in parts of Europe and Asia. A handheld computer is a portable computer that is small enough to be held in one's hand. Although extremely convenient to carry, handheld computers have not replaced notebook computers because of their small keyboards and screens. Traditional handheld computers for PDAs and devices specifically designed to provide PIM, personal information manager functions such as calendar and anti-spoof. Today, pocket PCs, smartphones, and tablets are common consumer devices. Types of handheld computers. Tablet. A tablet computer, commonly shortened to tablet, is a mobile device typically with a mobile operating system and touchscreen display, processing circuitry, and a rechargeable battery in a single thin and flat case. A tablet or tablet PC is a portable computer that uses a touchscreen as its primary input device. Most tablets are slightly smaller than weighs less than the average laptop. While some tablets include fold-out keyboards, others such as Apple iPad and Motorola Zoom only offer touchscreen input. Early tablet touchscreens were designed to work with light pens, but most modern tablets support human touch input. Many tablets now support multi-touch input, which allows you to perform gestures with multiple fingers, such as pinching an image to zoom out or spreading your fingers apart to zoom in. Tablets without physical keyboards allow you to enter text using a pop-up keyboard that appears on the screen. Skills tablets do not use a traditional keyboard and mouse as their primary forms of unit. The user interface of a tablet is different than a typical laptop. For example, instead of double-clicking to open a program or application, open with a single tap. Instead of clicking on a scroll bar to scroll through windows, most applications allow you to swipe up and down anywhere within a window to scroll through the content. Since tablet PC provide different interfaces than traditional computers, they offer unique possibilities for graphic application games and other programs. Because of the small form factor, they are extremely portable and can be easily stored in a backpack or a briefcase. Still, because tablets lack a keyboard and a mouse, some tasks such as typing documents and writing email messages are more difficult on tablets than traditional computers. Therefore, tablets are generally seen as accessories to laptops and desktop computers rather than replacements. Smartphone. A smartphone is a handheld electronic device that provides a connection to a cellular network. Smartphones allow people to make phone calls and text messages and access the internet. A smartphone is a mobile phone that can do more than other phones. They work as a computer, but our mobile device is small enough to fit in a user's hand. Uses include sending and receiving emails, text, photographs, and multimedia messages. Pocket PC. A pocket PC PPC is a hardware designed by Microsoft that is a small size analog device used for computing. The earliest model used the Windows CE operating system, with later model using the Windows Mobile operating system. Despite their small size, pocket PC had many of the same functionalities of contemporary PCs. Microsoft pocket PCs were introduced in 2000. Over the years, Microsoft evolved the pocket PC and released a number of Windows Mobile operating system edition for these devices. The hardware was made by several different manufacturers, but they were required to meet hardware and software specification in order to be classified as pocket PCs, including operating system, software, and user input control. Though there were no actual size specifications, pocket PCs were intended to be used as handheld devices. In 2007, Microsoft changed their naming scheme for pocket PCs. Gadgets with integrated phones were called Windows Mobile Classic devices, while those with touchscreens were referred to as Windows Mobile Professional devices. And devices without touchscreens were called Windows Mobile Standard devices. The pocket PC specification and Windows Mobile were discontinued in 2010 in favor of smartphones running the Windows Phone operating system. In terms of portability, the true pocket PC weighs somewhere between a 6 and a 12 weight of the weight of a notebook. Wearable computer. Wearable computer is a computer for carrying on the body. For example, on the wrist, it allows you to work, communicate, entertain right along, ensuring mobility and hands-free and or eyes-free access to the device. A clear specification standard for what is a wearable computer are not available yet. Nevertheless, from our point of view, the fundamental attribute of wearable computer is processing unit embedding the wearable device. In addition, there are some other features that are associated with wearable computer. For one thing, this technology is based on permanent communication between user and device. It's possible with numerous sensor devices that are becoming more widespread. As a rule, they track individual data during all day, even for 24 hours. Secondly, wearable computers are perfect for managers and people that are used to face with multitasking. They don't need to stop the operation of wearable mobile computer. Also, wearable enable changing, filtering, and blocking the info that is relevant or timely. And thirdly, wearable computer is more personal device than laptop or smartphone, as it is worn on the body, customized for the concrete person, and gather individual, often confidential information. Classification of wearable computers are smart glasses, smart watches, HMDs, smartphones, Ring, etc. In the link in the description, please click here to read more about wearable computers. In the wearable computer market, it was pretty device. Now, in our next lesson, will be elements of a computer system. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.